Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create the look of pencil drawings from photos. This is an update of similar tutorials I've done on earlier versions of Photoshop. The results in this version is more nuanced. Open a photo you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one and the others from Shutterstock. To ensure that your results will look similar to mine, let's check your photo size and resolution. Go to Image and Image Size. Make its width and height approximately this amount, give or take a few hundred pixels, but make sure its resolution is 150 pixels per inch. Next, we'll convert our image into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. It'll also allow us to replace our photo with another without having to redo the effects. To do this, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Make a copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Black and White. This desaturates the color from all the layers below it in the Layers panel. Hide the copy and make the bottom layer active. Go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Distort folder and click Diffuse Glow. Make the graininess 10, the glow amount 5, and the clear amount 7. At the lower right corner, click the Add Filter icon. Immediately, it added our last filter. Click the bottom one, which we'll change. Open the Texture folder and click Texturizer. The texture is sandstone, the scaling is 100%, the relief is 4, and the light is from the top. We now have two filters applied to our photo, Diffuse Glow and Texturizer. Make the copy visible and active. Go back to Filter and Filter Gallery. Hide both filters and open the Stylized folder. Click Glowing Edges and make it visible. Make the edge width 2, the edge brightness 20, and the smoothness 15. Click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Invert. To restrict it to affect just the glowing edges layer, click the Clipping Mask icon or press Alt-Ctrl-G on Windows or Option-Command-G on a Mac. You can also go to Layer and create Clipping Mask. Make the glowing edges layer active and change its blend mode to Linear Burn. We'll make the outline more transparent by reducing its opacity. I'll reduce it to 50%. I'd like to make the midtones a bit darker. If you want to do the same for your image, click the top layer to make it active, and click the adjustment layer icon. Click Levels. Drag the input midtone slider to the right to make the midtones darker. Lastly, if your image has some pencil lines that look a bit too strong, we can make them look less dense by making the glowing edges layer active and clicking the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask next to the glowing edges layer. Open your Brush Tool and Brush Picker. Pick a soft, round brush. We'll adjust its size in a moment. Make its hardness 0% and the opacity approximately 35%. Its flow is 100%. To adjust your brush's size, make sure your Caps Lock key is off and press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Now, brush over the lines that you'd like to make more transparent. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.